afternoon, there has been a major development in Australia's COVID vaccine rollout, with the medical regulator today approving Pfizer boosters for all adults. We'll go live to Canberra and our Politico reporter Fiona Willen. Fee, good afternoon. When will the booster program start?
Well, Davina, this could begin within a matter of days. So the Health Minister, Greg Hunt, says the program will start no later than the 8th of November. Today, Pfizer has been ticked off as a booster shot by the medicines regulator, the TGA. Now it just needs the green light from the government's vaccine advisory body, ATAGI, and it's expected that Pfizer will be approved as a universal booster for anyone over 18. So that will mean that it can be mixed and matched with other vaccines. So even if you're double dosed with AstraZeneca or Moderna, you can get a Pfizer booster. And that would be delivered at least 6 months after your second dose. Now, immunocompromised people have already been able to receive a third jab, but this would see boosters rolled out to the general population. And by the end of the year, 1.6 million people could be triple jabbed. Here's the Prime Minister.
The TGA approval, which gives those booster shot approvals for those over 18, 6 months apart, we'll be starting particularly with those in aged care facilities, like we did with the vaccine program.
Boosters may give additional protection against mild COVID, and they may have an impact on reducing transmission.
Now, there have been questions today of whether boosters will be added to your vaccine passport. And we're told while they will be recorded at this stage, they won't be required in order to qualify for quarantine-free travel, although that could change further down the track. And on the topic of travel, the government has now signed the paperwork to allow fully vaccinated Australians to head overseas without an exemption. So that will begin on the 1st of November. That's the same day that Victoria and New South Wales will ditch quarantine for fully vaccinated international arrivals. The government's been busy celebrating that today.
On Monday, Mr. Speaker, Australians will be taking off again. Australians will be taking off as the international restrictions on travel by vaccinated Australian residents and citizens is lifted.
And from the 8th of November, fully vaccinated Australians will be able to travel to Singapore without quarantining, and that's thanks to a new travel bubble deal. Some of the other countries that allow or will soon allow fully vaccinated Australians to enter without quarantine include the US, Italy, Greece, Germany, the UK, South Africa and Canada. And from the 1st of December, you'll be able to travel to Fiji and will only need to quarantine for 2 days in a resort hotel. And it's hoped that Bali will soon be added to that list too. Davina?
Fiona Willen, live in Canberra. Thank you. Well, COVID tests will soon be available around the clock to major supermarket chains, as well as service stations and convenience stores selling rapid antigen tests from as early as next week. Now, Coles is making the test kits available from 700 stores across the country. That's on Monday. They'll be available in packs of 2 and 5, and they're expected to cost between $10 and $30. Woolworths is yet to confirm an exact date, but has issued a statement saying they'll be available in selected stores from early November. They'll also be available 24/7 at petrol stations from next week, including 7-Eleven, Ampol and Coles Express. Well, the Victorian Premier and Prime Minister remain in a standoff over whether unvaccinated tennis players will be allowed into the state for the Australian Open. Let's go live to our reporter Mark Santomartino in Melbourne. Mark, good afternoon. The Premier doesn't want unvaccinated players allowed in.
Well, it wouldn't make much sense if you needed to be fully vaccinated to have a drink in the pub or even play AFL, Davina, but you could be unvaccinated and play at the Australian Open. Now, for days, Daniel Andrews has dodged having to enforce a no-jab, no-play rule under the state's mandate because it didn't look like the unvaccinated players would even be able to get into the country in the first place. That changed this morning, though, when the Prime Minister revealed those players would be allowed to fly in so long as they spent 2 weeks in hotel quarantine. But it's a loophole Victoria will not allow.
We will not be applying for an exemption for unvaccinated players to come here.
I think we just got to be sensible and practical, OK? We want major events in this country. A lot of jobs depend on it. We want Australia to show to the world that we're open, we're getting on with it.
Davina, it's unclear if players like Novak Djokovic, who has famously refused to disclose his vaccination status, could quarantine interstate. Unlike New South Wales, which will have the same rules for everyone from the 1st of December, the unvaccinated will be locked out in Victoria for some, if not all, of 2022. Daniel Andrews raising a few eyebrows today when he suggested that could include the fully vaccinated who fail to get a booster shot.
Are they going to lock people out of the economy who are double vaccinated but not got a booster? Where does it end?
Boosters are going to be part of our lives in 2022, and depending on the interval, it might even be into 2023.
Despite the fact we're opening up on the back of record testing, another 1,534 cases is welcome news, Davina. It's hoped infections have truly stabilised and will start trending downward. The number of Victorians in hospital with COVID has also dropped significantly.
That's good news, Mark. Thank you. It was only a matter of time. The NAB has followed the lead of the other big three and has started hiking its home loan rates. All fixed price loans will now cost more to borrow, and this is despite the Reserve Bank stating the official cash rate will stay on hold for the near future. The NAB has bucked the trend on 1 year fixed terms, dropping that rate by one percentage point. Our international borders will officially reopen after being shut off to the rest of the world for 18 months. From Monday, fully vaccinated Australians will be able to travel overseas without an exemption. And today, Singapore became the latest country to announce it will welcome back Australian travellers. And for more, we're joined by Michelle Zaja from Deja Vu Travel. Michelle, thanks for your time. I'd imagine business is starting to pick up, is it?
It is this week and last week, since the government have announced all the reopenings, especially with Singapore coming up on the 8th of November, we have been very busy.
Where are people wanting to go?
At the moment, we've got a lot of interest in Europe for 2022. So the summer coming up for Europe, USA over the winter period. So this Christmas and New Year's, and Asia is starting to really come hot on the market with us.
Are there any places at the moment that might be open but you're advising people not to go because the COVID rules are still moving and changing quite rapidly?
Yeah, well, I mean, we've got a lot of anxiety with booking anywhere just due to the caution of COVID. So Asia would be a definite place that we hit with caution, but we're telling everybody to do their own research because at the moment we just can't keep up with the continual changes of every government, every airline. The Australian government doesn't give us as much information as we need to know. So, yeah, Asia would probably be the most one that we have that we're being cautious with at the moment.
I guess for any country that you're travelling to, it's not just the country itself, but it's the hotels that you're going to be staying in, it's the airlines. What sort of boxes do you need to check to make sure you're aware of all the rules?
Yeah, well, with what I'm finding now with booking new people, especially for Europe, is that you find that the hotels are not being very flexible with their cancellation rates. So, for example, I'm booking Greece at the moment, and a lot of the rates are non-refundable. So we're looking to make things as refundable as possible, even if that person has to pay extra for them and their family or their business, just to make sure that our job at the end of the day, if things do take a turn like they did in 2019-20, we don't have to give people the bad news of no credit, no refund. Just making sure that we're covering every single aspect of the journey, and people aren't going to be so surprised if something does take a turn at the end of this year or in 2022.
Does travel insurance help in that process to cover you if there's a cancellation, but also to cover you if you get overseas and you get stuck and you get sick?
Well, what we've seen has been the biggest help is that the actual airlines are helping to cover those intricate details so that they have their own kind of COVID insurance, like Emirates, Etihad, probably one of our main carriers that we book, that have had a policy that really helps the travellers and draws them towards that airline. Insurance companies that we deal with are not back on the market for us. We're getting people to really do their own research through their credit cards, but I mean, you have to say, but insurance companies would be silly to open their doors so quickly, seeming that we're, you know, the world is not as clear and as safe as it should be. Okay. So no, insurance is going to be a lot harder. I think that's going to take a little bit of time and maybe come back beginning of 2022 should we be as free as we are or we're hoping to be.
It's so hard because everyone's busting to get out there and travel, but it's a bit of a minefield and a tap dance that you've got to work around all these issues. For you guys as well, you're also dealing with, I guess, staff shortages and other issues, as you mentioned, communication and updates from the Australian government. How are you juggling all this?
Well, look, it's been a major challenge. I guess the mental aspect has probably been the worst. I've lost pretty much all of my staff, which is not a surprise. I didn't even think that we would be surviving had this gone into mid-2022. So I'm actually lucky that I played my cards right and was able to stay alive, during the pandemic. So I don't have, I'm actually working solo at the moment. I will expand, it will happen again. It's not surprising. The government support really for the business itself, for people, it was okay. For the business itself, didn't allow us to continue with all the loss that we had with all of our clients trying to keep them happy. The business just was, it was hard for us to keep all of our staff. So no, at the moment, that's been one of the biggest challenges.
We hope things get back to normal as quickly as possible for you and for the travelling public as well. Michelle, thank you.
Thank you so much.